Welcome back to my channel. In this session we have this iPhone charging cable. The wires are damaged from this point. I am using this USB charging port, the inner grommet. Install it here. Set to continuity. In the rightmost pin, connect this wire, one lead here. So ground line is connected. The first pin here, the ground, and this side, the first pin ground. Now connect to the last one pin. So the last pin is not connected. If you see here, yes, this wire is damaged from here. Let's see it. Very carefully separate it from here. While removing, take care for this PCB, the small circuit here inside. Take a special care for this PCB. Yes, it is out. Connect to the rightmost pin and here to the black pin, that is the first pin here. It must give continuity. Then move to the second pin from right side. It is connected. Third pin, it is reaching here and there is no cross connection. Move to the positive pin, that is here. Connect here, it is not giving continuity. Now we can remove and we can install it another time. Remove insulation at the same length, that is here. Remove insulation from every wire. Make good thinning. I am using the flux filled solder wire. So I am not using the flux. If you are using simple soldering wire, at that time you will need to use flux soldering paste. Now I am holding this charging base in the helping hand. Now I will insert this heat shrink sleeve here. Now I will remove one wire at one time. Just refresh the solder, and when you are soldering, do a very careful soldering so that there should no bridging between the connections. The solder drop should not make short circuit between the two pins. It's good. Refresh the solder. When you replace the wiring for any system, remove just one wire and connect that wire. After that, do the next wire. If we remove all the wires the same time, if we don't have the wiring diagram, at that time it can make problem. If you cross one wire, all the system function will change. So it is a best practice to remove just one wire. Okay, now I connected all the wires. When you make connection between wires, all the wires must be at the same length. Now I connected to a charger, mobile charger, and we will check the voltage, DC voltage. We will check between the ground pin. It is reaching here. If we check at left pin, at point number 5 from the left sides. Here it is reaching 4.85 volt, so it's good because this time it is not using the ID resistance. Yes, the voltage are reaching here at these two points, point number 5, point number 1 from the left side, at point number 5 it is providing voltage. Check it here, the opposite side, both sides the same pin numbers must provide voltage 4.8 volt, that's good. When it will connect the mobile, at that time it will sense the mobile type and it will provide the proper voltage. This circuit will control the voltage. So let's pack it up. Now I packed it up and now we can, first I will make touching here. Now just to hold it, it's okay. Finally, we will check the voltage. DC voltage, first pin and pin number 5. Yes, that's good. Rotate the side, first pin and pin number 5. So this cable is now ready. I hope so this video is informative. If it is informative, hit the like button. If you have any question, let me know in the comment box. Thanks for watching.